Yeah.
Okay, cool. I am Aaron from Wesley, and again, we are hiring. So if Aaron, one person is possibly looking. So I'm here to talk about ASDF. Who here is familiar with what ASDF is, besides the first four letters in the home row? Just a couple people? Cool. Have you heard of RVM or RBNV? Yeah?
Yes.
Okay, cool. ASDF is that, but better. RVM and RBM handle Ruby, but we use a lot more tools in Ruby in our job. We use, just in some of my projects, we got Postgres, we got Redis, we got Node, some other things. So I'm going to talk about why ASDF is so great. And doing that, I'm just going to do a little demo here. So I have this project here. Project one. It's written in Golang, so I just want to make sure that I have the right version of Go. Actually, you know what? I don't have Go right now. All right, so let's try ASDF. Here are all the plugins that I have installed for ASDF. These are the ones that I'm using currently. I don't have Go in there. So easy enough, I can just say I want Golang. There we go. I don't actually have Go installed yet, but I have a plugin. So let's see, ASDF list all Golang. This will show me all the versions of Golang that I could possibly install. There's a lot of them. For this project, I need version 1.12.6. ASDF install Golang 1.12.6. We'll just download that real quick. And now I have Go installed. I just need to make sure that it's that the version that I just downloaded is the global version. So when I do this globally on my computer now, this version is the version that I'll use. So if I type Go version now, I can see I'm using 1.12.6. So that's great. No, I've got a version of Golang. But I've got this other project, project two. Thing is, this project uses Go version 1.5.4. We haven't updated it in a while, so I need to go back and make sure that I can use that. So let's install that. What did I say, 1.5.4? Now I'm downloading and installing it, but if I set my global version for Golang to this new version, then it's going to ruin my last project, and it's going to try to use the different version for that project. So instead of making that my global version, I'm going to make it my local version. And here, we're using Go 1.5.4. And I just want to show you how to do that real quick. So at the root of my project here, where I just said ASDF local, it creates this .tool versions file. And it says Golang. I'm using the version 1.5.4. Right, and then so for the global version, it does the same thing. There's no like real magic here. It just puts it in my home folder. You see down there, we got Golang 1.12.6. So what's going on here is that anywhere I try to access Go at this point, ASDF is going to take over. Go. Yeah, see, ASDF is my Go. And all it does is it looks for a tool versions file, so it'll work in my current directory. And if I can't find it, it'll go up the directory tree, try to find a tool versions file, and figure out what version that I should be running. So what's one of the things that's really cool about it, as I mentioned earlier, is it works for a lot of tools. A while ago, I was trying to figure out how to use multiple versions of Postgres. ASDF works with Postgres. I've got three versions of it installed right now. So right here, we're gonna add version 9.6.11. I mean, an older version, because we're using an older version of Golang anyway, right? Uh, degrees in proportion to 9611 to Postgres, and my tool versions file now has the Postgres line in it. So whenever we add more dependencies, it just adds another line. Oh, and my other project, project one, it uses Postgres also. So let's set something there, 11.3. We got region version 11.3 in here. So I just want to show you this real quick. When you say which go, it takes you to the asdf shim. Show you this real quick. That file is this one line here. It calls the asdf scripts, and that's the thing that it just goes through your directory tree and tries to find that tool versions file. Figure out what version to install. Let's see, asdf. There we go. Real quick, they support a lot of tools. So basically anything you might use at the command line that you want to have multiple versions of, you can get here. And it's pretty easy to create new extensions too, or new plugins. Oh, and another great thing about it is it's easy to uninstall stuff. So if we just uninstall 154, that's gone. Or if I just want to get rid of the plugin entirely. Go is gone. And that's ASDF. You have any questions? Miles?
Do you comment on the main?
ASDF? It is so easy to type. Like, I just go, done. It's not as easy as A or something like that, but I mean, it's gotta be unique. Any other questions? Josh?
If I don't have anything installed, but I have a tool versions file, can I install everything from that?
Pretty sure yes, but I didn't prepare that.
Yes, you can, because I did it today.
How do you do that?
You just, like, put in your tool versions, like, you know, Java, and then
just like that.
Yeah, if there's anything in your tool versions file that isn't installed, it'll just go through like one by one.
All right, let's see, asdf install. Okay.
So you still have to like add the plugin.
Well, that's cool. You taught me something, thank you. Any other questions? Yes?
For when you set a tool's version at the global level, is that global on the machine or is that global to your user account?
Your user account, as I showed you earlier, it's see I'm typing /, it's my home directory. So it's defining it on my home directory. Good question. Another question?
Say you're using this on a Linux distro and it provides Python, Ruby, a few other things as the system versions.
Yep.
Does it have a way of like integrating those system versions into what versions they are and being able to use them instead of locally installed?
Not that I'm aware of, but ASDF will definitely override whatever you have installed. It adds that ASDF file to that script to your path, and it puts it early in your path, or like I forget which direction it goes, but it puts it the right spot in the path to override everything else. Yeah, that's all I know about that. That's it. All right, thanks guys.